Something's not right with me.
Pilot requires further training. Activating automatic assistance. Stand by.
Assistance? I suppose I could use some pointers.
Let's begin by shooting targets.
Well, that seems easy enough.
The next targets have shields. First, use the pulse laser to deplete their shields. When the shields are down, use the Gatling gun to inflict greater hull damage.
Okay, understood.
Use missiles on the next targets. Set a target lock before shooting, so the missiles can home in. It appears as if you're ready for the next stage. I have created a jump target. Aim towards it and hold steady to leave the orbit. After each transit, your jump drive requires a cooling down phase. As soon as it is ready for another jump, I will create one. As you can see from your fuel gauge, a substantial amount was consumed during transit. You should aim to refill the jump drive completely. There is a mineable asteroid nearby. Shoot at it to extract fuel.
Should do it.
Remaining well provisioned is key to survival in the cluster. Before leaving the orbit, it is recommended you explore the location for resources. I have located a container at some distance.
Ah, resources.
And a weapon, but you don't have a free slot to install it. Decide for yourself whether you want to equip or salvage it. There is an outlaw ship incoming. I would advise activating your weapon overdrive in order to prepare for the encounter. This will enhance your weapon damage considerably.
I like the sound of that.
Resources are essential for crafting and upgrading your equipment. It appears, however, that we have exhausted our possibilities here. I suggest advancing to the next location.
What's my objective?
Reaching your destination.
And where is that?
It's still a long way to go. You will understand more when we get there.
I would prefer some more substance to your answers.
Your vessel harvests plasma automatically when you are near.
That's convenient.
Outlaws. Independent operators with varying affiliations profiting from trafficking, extortion, illegal weapons trading, piracy, clone smuggling.
Maybe they have something I need.
It appears we have stumbled upon an outlaw base. Scavengers and raiders of every degree ply the demilitarized zone using these hidden structures to launch operations. I would advise caution on approach.
Maybe it's worth the risk. That's just what I need.
As you have probably ascertained, hacking comm hubs has its benefits. Extracted raw materials. These are essential for crafting and upgrading, but you will require much more.
What's this mining outfit I'm registering?
Grady and Brunt Prospects, corporate behemoth and sole legitimate operator in the demilitarized zone. Their monopoly has ensured unchecked expansion. You will encounter their jump gates and mining drones frequently.
Thank you.
jump gates are the primary method of travel between systems. These were built by Grady and Brunt prospects for their mining drones to reach areas more efficiently.
Okay, thanks for the introduction. Now you want me to use this?
It is the only way to the next sector, so, yes.
Picking up on the broadcast channel here.
The Okar are a reptilian race with a tendency towards reactive behavior. They are indigenous to the cluster, and the Colonials uninvited guests. Distrust runs deep.
Credits.
Strange. Fragments of memories. Trying to make sense of them. I had managed to escape. I was weak and ill. My cells were deteriorating. A deadly poison. A cytotoxin. Slow, relentless, eating me away. There was a way to halt its progress, but it would take time. All I could do was set the wheels in motion and await the outcome in stasis. A long, uncertain sleep.
I saw myself again. Dying.
This must be a memory from your original. Apparently a flaw in the transference protocol. The Eterna system was meant to filter such personal recollections.
Wait, what are you saying? My original? I'm a
clone, yes. Usually this is not realized by limited use copies. The function of Eterna was to pass on operational skills, such as piloting. But it seems that something has gone wrong here.
Stop. This is a lot to take on board all at once. Why is this happening? Who am I? Who is my original?
I have no information on that. Perhaps there is a purpose to this aberration which will become clear upon reaching the coordinates given. I have no answers, unfortunately. But I am as curious as you are.
How did Grady and Brunt manage to get the only contract in the DMZ?
They were first on the scene, due to their extensive jump gate infrastructure. So far as their monopoly is concerned, their close working relationship with the Colonial Fleet was undoubtedly a factor. Acquiring a taste for cast-offs, by the looks of things.
Giant shipwrecks. What are they?
Colonial Fleet warships overwhelmed by Okar fighters during the war. You will find such wrecks scattered throughout the demilitarized zone. This will enhance your weapon damage considerably.
I like the sound of that.
Is a service station. Do you know what happens in a service station?
I thought I asked the questions here.
Do you?
Refuel? Trade parts?
You're learning.
Why does does this vessel appear with a skull?
This is to highlight a superior fighter. It will be harder to take down.
We'll have to see about that. Trading ship?
Apparently so. Quite fortuitous to encounter one in these parts.
About time.
Thank you.
not good. It's spikes.
Hostiles incoming.
Lightning in space? How?
Magnetic fields causing friction. An anomaly.
But quite visually striking.
Hostiles are targeting us. This is a former colonial station, abandoned as a wreck following the war with the Oka.
Will I find anything interesting inside?
It is a possibility. However, my scanners indicate that some systems are still online, including the security protocols.
I knew it. Nothing comes for free. Waste is another man's treasure.
Memories are not my own. They are copies. They originate from someone else. It was at the Fleet Academy. His name was Adam. Adam Roslin. Quiet, reserved, awkward around the others. He had a friend, Seth. They shared a dorm. Basic training was tough. Seth looked out for Adam. He stood up for him. The brains and the brawn. They became close, like a team. And then the orders came. Deployment for war against the Okar.
Another vision. And I think I know my name. Adam. Adam Roslin.
Interesting.
Do you have any information on that name?
I do not. But this level of cognizance in a clone is highly unusual. I would like to help you learn more in order to understand how this happened.
Let's find some answers.
Thank you. ship component is damaged. It is recommended you fix it before your next encounter.
If you say so.
Better value by weight.
Enemies
in range.
New.
Okay, thanks for the warning.
He has a jump suppressor. This does not bode well.
Who would have thought that outlaws make such good informers? But they were right. You're still alive.
I'm not sure we've been introduced.
What you did was unnecessary. Destroying it all. How could you? After all the efforts we put into our plans, you betrayed me.
Listen, I think you have the wrong man. I don't want any trouble.
I don't play the fool. Look, I hate to do this, but I can't let you get away with this, Adam.
Adam? Wait. I've seen you before. Your name is Seth.
What do you take me for? You can drop the amnesia act. It's time for you to pay.
This Seth guy. I remember him vaguely. We were friends, weren't we? Why did he try to kill me?
It should not come as a surprise that most people want to kill you. This one was rather talkative.
Talkative? He accused me of something I did and I can't remember. What have I done? Who am I?
Damn you, Adam! This isn't over yet!
Now that was a curious encounter.
Whoa. of story elements. Spoiling a lot of new things for you now. So much gas. Scrap.
Flotsam. Or, Jetsam.
They arrived at Cluster 34, into a cauldron of hellfire, a war of unprecedented intensity. Seth Nobu was an ace fighter, earning his badges quickly in combat. Adam Roslin was on the same carrier, cloning new troops for the front. The war was mutually devastating, but mercifully short. With an armistice, the fleet had to withdraw, but some wanted to stay behind for the spoils, new opportunities. Seth Nobu was among this group. Adam Roslin went with the fleet. Complying with the peace conditions, his cloning program was dissolved.
Seth Nobu. He was a friend.
In which case, next time you could perhaps convince him not to shoot at us.
If only I knew what my original did to make him so angry. What did he mean by betrayal?
It appears that you must navigate Adam Roslin's past in order to find the answers.
I just need to put the pieces together. destruction is breathtaking.
Hostilities only ceased when resources were exhausted, forcing both sides to the negotiating table. The demilitarized zone was created as a buffer zone, monitored by the Okar authorities. Only time will heal the rift between the species.
This could be a sticky situation here.
Oh, fuck.
Sure is beautiful here.
Do not allow your general sense of amazement to distract you from the more pertinent dangers.
Are we any closer to our destination?
Our objective will be reached in due course. Clearing our path there is our primary current concern.
this cost was a squeeze of the trigger.
Taking damage! Been detected.
Reconstructing Cluster 34 would be an enormous task. Logistics for this new frontier were key. Seth Nobu had worked hard to build his business. He had the prestige, the contacts, and he greased every palm along his path. He was soon the biggest weapon supplier around, artfully circumventing the treaties. He had a simple reason for seeking out Adam Roslin again. Demand for illegal human clones. Adam needed some convincing. He had doubts. But in the end, the friendship held, and a deal was struck.
Seth Nobu and my original worked on something together. We were partners.
Whatever went wrong between you two, he obviously maintains a grudge. It would be preferable if you got to the root of the disagreement so he can stop shooting at us.
I have a feeling there's more to follow.
result.
Straight into the account. We've got company.
Direct monetary reward for your endeavors.
There's a few of them.
Not one dot.
Yeah, I like that. Locked onto me. This big boy looks dangerous.
An Oka Corvette. It is indeed most very likely to be hazardous to your general well-being.
Hey there, do you need some supplies?
Hmm? Who are you?
I'm just a friend. Make good use of the things I left you. We'll meet again soon.
Thanks, but why are you helping me?
I'm in a good mood today. Look, just be thankful of some random support when you can get it, okay?
They've locked onto you. She jumped away.
Well, there's no reason to complain, but it's strange all the same.
She's lifting it fucking up.
This is bad.
Get back or take evasive action.
Taking damage. Cross another one off.
Come on.
thing is massive. What is it?
These must be the ruins of the ancients, a long-lost civilization. Although the information I have on them is very limited.
Just tell me what you know.
They were believed to be higher beings, distantly related to and revered by the Oka. They ruled over a powerful and far-reaching empire, yet they mysteriously vanished from historical record some millennia ago.
Interesting. Perhaps I should explore this a little deeper. What is this? It seems abandoned. Are these ancients?
I cannot confirm this as I have no data. They could also be some kind of wardens of the ruins. This does change things somewhat.
Whoa! What's happening? What's going on here?
It was only a matter of time before their illegal cloning venture was uncovered. The colonial authorities apprehended them during a raid. They were resigned to see out their days on a penal base. But there was one in the High Command with different plans for them. Colonial Fleet Admiral Kryn Gork. He offered amnesty in return for their cooperation on a covert project. He needed Seth's facilities and Adam's expertise for decrypting the Okar genome. Wanted it done in secret. The offer was preferable to a prison moon.
I had another vision. Maybe more clues. There was a high-ranking colonial commander.
Do you recall the name?
He was an admiral. By the name of Gork.
Yes. Kryn Gork is a rather powerful figure.
Okay, so the plot thickens. responsible for leaving all these containers floating around?
Fallen off the back of a long-distance freighter, in all likelihood.
I've found you again.
Seth, wait, I'm beginning to recollect.
Oh, really? Good for you. So what is your plan? Where are you going?
I don't know exactly. I have coordinates, that's all. I'm trying to find some answers. Believe me, I want to know what this is all about just as much as you do.
Wait, interesting. Coordinates. I knew it! You're a clone! I'm talking to a meatbag! Oh, Adam, what have you done? I'll let you go for now. Try not to cross me again, clone.
Well, that was a bizarre conversation. What does it mean?
It appears that you have some history with this individual. Perhaps there is some unfinished business, but we have our mission to fulfill. Shall we carry on, or theorize endlessly?
Adam Roslin succeeded in decrypting the Okar genome. The Admiral was satisfied with the work they had done. Now he could progress to the next stage of his plans. Using the decrypted genome, he wanted to create a brigade of Okar clones to incite fresh conflict between the races. With a new war, he could finally defeat the Okar and establish colonial supremacy in the cluster. The Admiral offered them a part in his scheme, with all its privileges for their ongoing cooperation. Seth Nobu accepted the offer. Adam Roslin would not stand for reviving a war. He refused to take any part in it. But the Admiral had more crude methods of persuasion, injecting Roslin with a controlled cytotoxin. Roslin was given no choice but to comply. Nobu made no objection. His interests were clear.
I saw that Admiral again. Another piece of the puzzle. My original was forced to work on an illegal cloning program. He refused out of principle.
So Adam Roslin did not carry out the task?
It seems they put him in a compromising position. They poisoned him. That's all I remember.
These flashbacks, like scraps of being, are difficult for me to understand. I dwell more in the interconnectedness of things.
user joined your channel.
Hi. Jetzt ist Pen and Paper vorbei. So. Nice.
Quasi von keiner zu existiert eine extrem große Story. Weiter als normal. Das war noch viel, ich kann die so hoch.
Haben sie die runtergestellt oder hast du dich für eine niedrigere entschieden?
Also, weil ich erst keine Entscheidung schwer ist, habe ich es einfach auf den Leib gestellt. Also, gleich mit Cinematic für Story und so weiter. Ich schätze mal, normalerweise kriegt man nur an diesen einen Sektor erreicht eine neue Story, aber jetzt kriege ich halt jeden Sektor eine neue Story. Daran, dass ich einfach nicht sterbe zurzeit, was komisch ist. Ich spiel's halt eigentlich auf hart. Gegner kommen früher, Gegner sind stärker, Gegner sind Ressourcen und so weiter und so fort. Machen wir auch gute Changes. Ich zum Beispiel diese Wände gewohnt, die man halt immer jede Zone ausgebaut hat, wenn man immer gefeuert hat. Also komplett rausgenommen.
Another to Stardust.
Kann ich gar nichts. Wait, no. Oh, weiter. Drop eben wäre ich jetzt schon gestorben.
My instruments are acting up. These clouds are made of highly densed and supercharged particles. They are interfering with the sensors.
Oh, that's just what I need.
Thank you.
drawing fire. Intercepted.
Betrayed by Seth Nobu. Adam Roslin worked under guard in his captor's laboratory. The cytotoxin was killing him slowly. The Admiral held the antidote. Roslin's only options were work or die. But he devised his own solution to the problem. Copying all incriminating data and destroying the research, he made his move.
Mahlzeit.
So he fled to somewhere he had worked before. A secret lab in the demilitarized zone.
Na, was macht die Kunst?
Another memory came to me.
Nichts Neues.
So he did not succumb to the poison.
He was suffering from it, at least. He made it to a hidden lab. Our destination, perhaps.
We are not to discovering that. The coordinates point to a system only one sector away.
The whole story is within our reach. Let's get this over with.
Bitte?
Ich bin Everspace und gerade war viel stabiler.
Oh, kein Problem. Ich hab's gerade hingekriegt, die Kleine ins Bett zu bringen. Ja. Die hat ihren Schlafrhythmus, dass sie zwischen 12 und 1 richtig pennt. Manchmal was früher, manchmal was später, aber zwischen 12 und 1 ist so ihr Alter, ihre Zeit, das ne? Fire extinguishing. Da habe ich auch schon den First Win drauf. Ja, World of Warships. Ich finde das Konzept ja geil, aber so einige. Sound muted.
Sound resumed.
A jump suppressor is active nearby.
That's not good.
Well, do something about it. Find it and disable it. The higher the signal strength, the closer you are.
Thank you.
drawn the attention of hostiles.
There, I was worried.
The odds were certainly against you. Phase incomplete.
Yes, all right.
How much longer I could have endured that.
Me neither.
Ha 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 ha.
darf nichts mehr über Net Neutrality lesen. Die Firmen werden ja immer schlimmer. Hast du das mitbekommen, dass die Firmen jetzt zuerst, weil FCC ist ja diese offizielle, ja, was ist denn die richtige Meinung? Und wie heißt es, wie es aussieht, hat in Amerika einer der großen Firmen hat dann halt gesagt, ja, okay, wir nehmen jetzt einfach mal random von unseren Kunden ihre Daten und unterschreiben, dass sie dafür dagegen sind, dass Net Neutrality noch so bleibt, wie es ist. Das heißt, die wollen das sozusagen erzwingen und erpressen. Und jetzt nehmen sie halt mittlerweile auch tote Leute, die sich plötzlich bei Net Neutrality melden und sagen, ja, wir wollen, dass Net Neutrality entfernt wird.
Also der Trick ist, steigt ein mit toten Wählern.
Ja. Das Problem ist, dass es relativ einfach ist, weil die meisten Leute sich sowieso mit nichts beschäftigen, was länger ist als ein Tweet. Das ist doch das Problem. So kommt doch ein Donald Trump auch an die Macht. Leute beschäftigen sich nicht mit Programmen. Die haben ein Kurzzeitgedächtnis oder ein Gedächtnis, das vielleicht 2 Wochen zurückreicht. Ja. Ne?
Der neue Schluss.
Genau, und dann kann man den Leuten auch einfach alles verkaufen.
Ja, aber was ich krass finde, ist halt, ja, okay, du bist Kunde bei uns, also nehmen wir jetzt deine Daten und unterschreiben damit mal eine andere Petition.
Ja, das ist,
Ich brauche noch, dass sowas existiert.
Ja, aber das ist das, was so brutal ist daran, dass halt, dass das immer mehr, die Firmen halt immer aggressiver versuchen.
Klar, ich meine,
wir werden auch immer dümmer, oder? Wir kommen auch immer mehr durch.
Wahrscheinlich. Ja, doch. Concentrate on them before taking on the character. Ja, hier war es Hitler und jetzt ist es Trump. Die Qualität sinkt an Qualität.
Qualität der Bossgegner, oder wie?
Die Qualität der Raid-Bosses sinkt.
Kann man doch die Leute auf mit WoW zu spielen.
Der Schlachtschiffkapitän, der hier rumguckt, verflucht mich wahrscheinlich gerade. Na komm.
Fuck, jetzt zerstört den Transporter für mich. Bitte, 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 bitte. Ja. Do it! Nee, tut's.
Trick ist, man wackelt einfach nur die ganze Zeit mit dem Hintern. Und man guckt.
Das klingt sehr universell. Definitiv eine universelle Lösung.
Ja.
Das ist genauso wie... Ach Gott, ey. Die Session heute war sehr, sehr merkwürdig.
Was für eine Session?
Ich hab heute Blades in the Dark, den One-Shot, den ich geleitet habe, zu Ende geführt.
Ja, ja.
Das ist sehr... hatte sehr... sehr... fragwürdige Kombination von... schwulen Andeutungen über Kinderpornografie, über Kindergewalt und so.
Bitte.
Was spielt ihr da? Habt ihr jetzt ein Kinderheim aufgemacht und überlegt, die
Weisheit? Nein, nein, nein. Also, sagen wir es so. Wenn, ohne Kontext ist das genau das, was ich gesagt habe. Aber es war halt so. Der eine ist halt im Ausland, ne, also Ausländer, dann hat er halt wie heißt es, hat er dem anderen geholfen und hat ihn halt dabei an der Hand gefasst. Der andere sagt, so, what the fuck, reagiert halt darauf, weil er es nicht gewohnt ist anzufassen. Dann hat einer gesagt, keine Sorge, es ist so wie immer das erste Mal. Und grinst ihn dabei an. Und das war halt einfach nur Fail in Übersetzung, weil für ihn war das halt nichts Sexuelles, aber sprachliche Membran. Und dann denkst du so, okay.
Roll for translation. One. Fuck.
Roll for persuasion. Roll to charm. Brit. So, und das andere ist, die haben sich halt einen Geist gefangen, der halt in... und das war halt dieser Typ, der halt nicht so sehr die Sprache halt richtig beherrscht, ne? Ist halt ein Geist von einem kleinen Kind halt aufgetaucht bei ihnen in der Umgebung und hat halt rumwandaliert, ja, und sagt, ah, ich will spielen und ist halt überall rum. Ist er halt hingekommen und dann hat er halt Ghost Fist, das heißt seine Fäuste halt, seine ganzen Tattoos haben angefangen zu leuchten und seine Fäuste sind halt alles schwarz geworden, ja. Und dann sagt er, ja, komm her, und stellt sich dann hin, willst du mit mir spielen? Ich spiele mit dir. Ich dachte, wieder ein Phänomen. Und hat dann halt angefangen, dieses so, das war zwar ein Geisterkind, ja, aber hat dann dieses Kind halt niedergeprügelt. Und ich bin so, okay. Und das war halt so irgendwie so dieses komische Theme, was über das Spiel gelaufen ist. Du denkst, okay, bist du jetzt wirklich nur ein Kämpfer oder ein Sexabuser?
Klassiker bei solchen One-Shots. Ja. Solche One-Shots haben wir meistens bei Vampire gespielt. War auch mal sehr verheerend. Oder bei Shadowrun.
Die Systeme fand ich. Also, Vampire geht wahrscheinlich, aber. Shadowrun fand ich. Sehr. Finde ich dafür zu komplex, um einen kleinen One-Shot daraus zu machen, aber es könnte wahrscheinlich gehen.
Ja, also, du kannst ja auch immer teilweise gucken, was für Regeln du mit reinnimmst.
Ja, stimmt.
Du kannst ein bisschen einschränken. Naja, und diese meisten Abenteuer starteten irgendwie mit dem Treffen in einer Kneipe, irgendeiner Spelunke, die Left Hands Inn hieß. Immer. Meistens hat die Kneipe das auch nicht überlebt.
Na dann.
Also der One-Shot bestand, dieser Spielabend bestand auch meistens nur daran, dass wir die Kneipe zerlegt haben und manchmal ist dann auch der Auftraggeber mit draufgegangen.
Oh Mann.
Ich muss euch ja mal kurz. Ja. So, Mikrofon muted.
After a painful voyage, Adam Roslin finally reached the secret lab. His DNA code was recognized by the defense system. To his shock, the entire facility had been made unusable. Time was running out. But there were other cloning facilities. Carriers, abandoned bases, scattered throughout the demilitarized zone. Too far to reach. Remotely, he brought one of them back online, initiating an exploit protocol. If the plan worked, it would bring him a body replacement. In his fever, he made mistakes. But the wheels were set in motion. In the meantime, the cryo chamber would halt the cytotoxin's progress. A long, uncertain sleep.
We have reached our destination. Our mysterious friend has joined us. She must have followed us.
Hey there! You're the first clone to have made it!
What are you doing here? What is this place?
I'm not sure yet. Let's fly in closer and see.
Seth Nobu is here.
It seems a few people have been waiting for me to complete this mission. What's this all about?
I've guessed what this place is. Have you?
The original Adam Roslin's hideout.
It took you long enough to get here.
Why, Nobu? Why can't you just leave the past be?
It's Adam Roslin I want, not you. There's a matter to be settled and you play no part anymore.
I have run a diagnostic of the facility defenses. The entrance is DNA coded to your specific sequence.
Okay, so only I can open the gates. This must be part of Rosalind's plan. But what about these guys?
You must be unaccompanied for entrance to be granted. The entire facility is booby-trapped against any attempted breach.
You won't get in, Nobu. Time for you to drop your grudge.
Listen, you brainless clone. I'm here for revenge, and that's what I'm gonna get.
Stand aside, Nobu. You've done enough damage.
Dinara? Oh, Dinara. So you were the mystery helper. You should never have gotten involved. Your brother became something quite different from the man you knew. These clones are no substitute.
My brother is in there, Nobu, and I intend to rescue him!
Dinara? Roslin's sister? Now things are starting to make sense. Wait, what is she doing? Dinara, wait!
Nobu has tactical support. She is heading straight into a trap.
No!
She brought it on herself. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have some business to finish with an old friend.
Seth, you've done enough.
You don't get the right to use my name, meatbag. Just die!
We gotta prevent him from getting inside.
He will be unable to enter the facility without the proper DNA sequence. Just take care of his support first. this was only the vanguard. Prepare yourself for more.
I'm still trying to process that Denaro was my original sister. Why didn't she reveal herself to me?
Saving Adam Roslin was her primary objective. It is likely she could not allow herself to become emotionally attached to the multiple clones she was supporting.
Did she see anything of her brother in me? I'll never know now. What is this place anyway?
An abandoned colonial research station from the war. Made unusable when it was decommissioned. But some of the systems are still intact. You could activate some of the turrets if you get close enough.
That would help. won't be sharing that information.
I'll find a way in without you.
must surely exhaust his supply of fighters soon.
I hope you're right. This can't go on forever. Insane? How did Seth get all these outlaws on his side?
They were undoubtedly bought.
Thank you. that's that.
You did well. I register no further jump signatures.
I just hope Seth didn't already gain access.
My scanners indicate that he is still alive and near the entrance.
All right. Let's end this once and for all.
Something has changed. These are my memories. I made it inside the hangar. There was Nobu, lying injured by the defense system. He was still alive, barely. I had so many questions, but didn't know where to start. He fixed me with his gaze. Then he laughed, mocked me. He seemed crazed, rabid with pain. In that moment, I didn't know whether to hate him or feel compassion for him. I had to make a decision. In the end, I realized that to start the next chapter of my story, his story had to end. With Nobu dead, my DNA was validated by the system. I was led to the lab. There he was, Adam Roslin, my original. Waking from stasis. We looked at each other for a long time. It was a moment of reckoning. Then we talked, perhaps for hours. Roslin was filled with remorse, heavy with regret. He seemed to realize that I was not just a dull clone. He admitted his plan was ill-constructed, What was expected was a body replacement. What arrived was a person. A thinking, feeling being. Me. Roslyn had reached the end of the line, and my lifespan was limited too. The clone sequencing he initiated had left me flawed. There was a chance for me to carry on, but not Roslyn. So he instructed me in what to do. With the missing DNA fragments, I could use the lab's transfiguration pod and make myself complete. He showed me how to localize the fragments on the star map. Out of stasis, it didn't take much longer for the cytotoxin to finally do its work and kill Roslyn. I had much to do. There were new possibilities, although time was limited in my current iteration. I needed a fresh body, and there was only one way to get it.